Ah, we are going there.
Okay.
Woo! Athan Sophomore.
Damn.
Sounds Greek. Are you Greek?
Yeah.
Oh shit.
How long is the drive from here to Zermatt?
Three hours.
3 hours, huh?
And more.
Check it out.
Oh!
What come on?
Nos dimos todo lo que se nos dio. Nos dimos todo eso y mucho más.
For me, one of my dreams was to go to the mountains. In this trip, we got to experience that. And that perhaps was one of the best experiences in my life. Being in the wheelchair myself, you know, I don't really get to go to the beach a lot because I can't maneuver around the sand. And with the snow, it's the same thing. But I was very fortunate to have you, Evan, Joseph, Mikey, Rob, Steven, and Omid. Omid's a really fun guy. Really loves traveling and just getting to know the world. That's what keeps me going as well.
Guys, are the numbers doing really good today?
Joseph! Fucking hurry, the train is fucking here.
Please.
Get the fuck out of here.
I told you.
Yeah, hey, bro, it's like a cockroach when you roll.
You can't move.
And then he was just rolling, bro.
Hey, it's a win-win. We get both the train ride and the car ride, so it works.
Records the video that you're recording.
Yeah, bro.
The Evans recording. That's the whole car.
Everybody's recording.
For me, just seeing the smiles and all of you guys, it really makes me really happy. Since the beginning of time, there's always been people traveling with me, a lot of the guys from here in the shop. Being the first time in the snow, you know, just being helped by you guys and pushing me up the mountains and sliding down and fucking taking people down as we rolled down the mountain, it was something magical. You know, it was something that I really want everybody else here in the shop to experience.
Strawberry
in the end.
Come on, get it, Evan.
I'm feeling really good, man. I'm just out here up in the Swiss Alps at the Matterhorn. I'm just enjoying everything right now. The wind, the snow, just everything. I'm just having a really good time.
These parts, you cannot put so much weight.
Oh, yeah.
You shouldn't put weight.
It's the thing.
You can sit in front of him.
We have indoor pool, outdoor pool, sauna, wellness.
Is that open tonight?
No, only until 7:45.
Oh, it closes, yeah?
And we're here?
Yes.
Fuck, I'm gonna get settled in. My man, look at this.
Ooh-wee.
Jesus. All right, let's get some stuff.
Everybody
claims that they want the best thing. That's just in case.
Hopefully there'll be other times when we get to go back and do it all over again with a little bit more experience this time, because this last time we did not know what we were in for, you know, but you learn a lot from that, just putting yourself in a position and making the best of it.
Homie, was that place all sold out or what?
Check that one out on top.
Dad, bro.
Wait, hold on. You're a piece of dog.
Take three.
Holy
shit. Hey, someone got it, bro.
Homie, nice to know you slip back and your face hits that shit, bro.
Ready?
Oh.
Good.
Fuck that, bro.
Oh, shit.
Yo, watch out, Mikey. Get the fuck out of
Frosty the homie man.
As simple and quiet as it was, it was an amazing experience, you know.
Man,
This is a fresh cracker with some fresh cheese. And inside over there is some tomato and red hot red pack. Enjoy.
E incominciavo a volare nel cielo infinito.
Hey, quit fucking grabbing.
He's good.
Hey, you got it on tape.
You got hit hard right now.
To explain, and it's really, really difficult, you know. I guess in a nutshell, you put yourself in a position where things are very difficult to pull off, you know. This is after you consider the money that it takes to do all these things. Getting from one place to another, getting in trains, you know, getting up in the morning, getting ready, sometimes finishing tattooing at fucking 7 a.m, literally taking a shower, put a different set of clothes on, packing all your stuff, calling a ride that's gonna take you to another city that's 4 hours away, while carrying mountains of luggage, you know, wanting to go to sleep on the way there, but not wanting to miss the beautiful scenery along the way, you know, these are things that you cannot explain to people. You can only bring him and put him in that situation. And that's when either the magic happens or it turns into a nightmare.
What's up, buddy? I'm about to go get a handful of ice or a handful of snow.
Let's go lay in it. Go lay in it, bro.
One thing that sucks is there's so much snow that you can't really see the top of the mountain.
We gotta do it now and then go to the city.
Yeah, yeah. And then we'll ask the girl if there's like a little baby slope.
That slope that you went down, that's it. That ain't no bunny slope.
Look, no. Hey, you're seeing the people go down.
I was watching.
I
wanted
that there's only like certain slopes we could go down. Bunny slopes.
Yeah.
Damn, yeah, I mean, we could walk down there if you guys want to like, take some pictures or something.
Hey, go to the top and do the penguin maneuver, folks.
Get a trash bag and just like wrap it on your stomach.
Don't get this man wrong. He's a 5-time Olympic skier. And we ain't talking on snow.
Hey, guys.
I'm going to put him up first.
See that red fence is? Start there. Come this way.
Why don't you go this way and then turn this way, bro?
Do a practice one where maybe it's not so high and then see how it is. Like halfway, bro. Damn, you're really going all the way already.
Yeah. Want to? Yeah,
I'm gonna go that way, but I see you're gonna be out of the fucking way.
Holy, he's already in the way!
You can't go up that high.
Huh?
You can't go up that high.
It's fucking cold, yo. My hands are freezing. As you can see, it's fucking snowing over here.
Like halfway, I can clear that corner right there.
This wheel would have went down first, so you would have tipped.
That's why I was worried, bro.
Oh, see,
I'm fucking serious, bro. I'm right here and see how you turn.
Yeah.
Come this way.
Yeah, because it's pretty flat right here.
If he calls out, just let him go.
She got herself on like
if
this.
If he hits this, we stop him from here.
Nah, bro.
Can you help me out, Joseph?
Oh,
fucker.
All right, hold on. No.
Oh, no, I really fucked my rib. Fucking on me, bro. I'm fucking going, I was going right. What the fuck, you blocked me?
You told me, they told me.
There's no fucking
nothing, bro.
I said I'm going this way so that I don't have to go stop over there. Ah, I should put the wind out of me.
Let's go.
All right. You know, skiing. Look, he had to fucking push me, bro.
I wasn't trying.
Look, Mommy, I was fucking going
you
good, bro.
That side too.
He always ends up on that side, bro. So I'm trying to get this side. He ain't coming, bro.
I would have crashed into the little house there.
Wild coyote.
The wild coyote. Hey, you see the fucking the silhouette
imprint?
Yeah.
Like that. I mean,
bro, I want all that fucking evidence stricken from the fucking record of Lowrider, bro. This should never happen, bro.
What I think is the most difficult, it's not necessarily us tattooing, you know, but it's always the people that are just there supporting us, hanging with us, getting the same hours of sleep with us, and not doing anything, you know, like doing it day after day. You still have to function. You still have to keep the camaraderie with one another. You know, you still have to be, you know, helpful and seeing how you can make things easier for one and the other. I always saw myself concentrated working on something, but when I see everybody else, I always say that that's a lot more difficult than what I do.
I fucking told you.
We're all going through situations like this, whether you're traveling, whether you're stuck somewhere you don't want to be in. You got to make difficult decisions. And sometimes we can blame, you know, being tired, you know, or not wanting to be there, or it's not what I expected. We can find many different things to complain about, but I guess if there's one lesson that we can all learn from this is that no matter what you find yourself doing or what place or under what circumstances, you really have to make the best of everything.
Mike's hooking it up.
They're sick, bro. It looked good on you.
So what they saying? Yeah, they do.
Five-year wait list, bro, for the GMT and Daytonas.
Oh, no, you gotta hug it, fool. Like,
yeah, yeah, hug it like you know.
There you go.
Oh man, the Rolls Royces are fucking watches, bro. To take the Leafs over here. I don't even have prices listed on these things.
Wanna try it, bro?
What is it? Is it white chocolate?
I'm not sure, man.
You gotta get a white chocolate one, bro. You should always expect the best, bro.
Hello.
And
they got all the flavors here.
They got strawberry, bro. Strawberry right here.
It's a lot of different challenges that can make somebody not want to do it ever again. But there's also a lot of magic that goes on and that happens. And as you're coming back on the plane, you know, just wondering how the fuck you got through this trip, at the same time, you know, you're thinking, well, what am I going to do next? Whether it be ambition or motivation, where is it going to take you next? I think that's just a way of coping with life, you know, and instead of giving up, you know, like finding hope that would take you to a different place and search for more inspiration and just to learn a little bit more about how other people think.
This bottle of water
was for you and only you
my shoes.
Damn,
that
water
too.
What is that?
Oil?
Oh, this is a little fucking pull. Screen right here.
Find a way.
This is normal, man.
That's what I mean. That's how this dragon neck look, bro.
Nah, that ain't
put it in the fire? Baby,
homie, quit stoking it so goddamn much, bro.
I wouldn't do that to you, but you are my friend.
Him stoking that shit so goddamn much got me fucking scared as motherfucker,
gesture,
bro.
It means all the world to me, bro.
Man.
I wouldn't do that to you, bro.
Dude, I was ready, bro.
I'm still gonna put it on your fucking eyeball.
But I thought.
Wait.
He said, I ain't wasting a cigar.
Bro, we just got fucking trapped in a city. And we need to go way up into the top of the mountain, bro. And they're fucking closed. So it looks like we're all gonna sleep on that little sled right there. And Joseph's all gonna fucking pull us all the way to the top of the mountain. And if he drops or fucking loses any of us, that's his ass.
Birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Cocaine Rock. Happy birthday to you.
transformed now, bro. Like, I can still see
it. I mean, you don't know if it fits yet, or like.
Yeah, it's all white.
No, that's too many, but I can come back.
Hey, someone just in the chair, bro.
Yeah. That's
pretty dangerous. So is this, bro.
So is this, dog.
Hey, you come up for your bed, I'll follow me, bro. Because you're gonna sound, Hey, Rob!
I think with tattooing, you know, we're very privileged to be in the front seat of these experiences. You know, it takes us all over the world. There's always somebody that, without us even knowing, it's watching us, it's seeing what we do. You know, they're learning. You know, they're embracing the things that we do, the things that we're into. 10,000 memories. Feels really good when you get to a new place and you get that reward of hearing somebody say, wow, like, I've been wanting to meet you guys forever. And now that you guys are here, it's like a dream come true, you know? So I think that's the beginning of somebody else being inspired. It just becomes a circle of life. Just, you know, you inspire somebody and then before you know it, they come back around and they inspire you. That's amazing.